Good morning, children. Welcome back to our geography class. In our last videos, you have seen about the types of natural vegetation, children. Those are forests, grasslands, and shrubs. In today's class, you will be able to learn about the types of forests. Okay. Now, let's start our class with the first forest, children. That is what you know, evergreen forest. Children, have you ever seen evergreen forest? Yes, they remain green all round the year, right? They're evergreen. So now let us learn about this evergreen forest. Where can you see this kind of forest? Where do you find this kind of forest? Okay, so they are called tropical evergreen forest. It means what? No, these air forests are found in the tropical areas. Here you can see, children, tropical region. See, equator. This is the equator. The areas which are close to equator in the tropics, and these are two tropics, Tropic of Capricorn, Cancer, and Tropic of Capricorn. So the areas which are near to these two tropics, you can find this kind of forest. Okay, so they receive rainfall throughout the year. That's why they remain hot and wet. Daytime it will be so hot and nighttime it will be so cold. And by evening, every day it rains, children. That's why the region remains hot and wet. And you know, children, there is no dry season for this forest. There is no dry season. That's why the trees in this region will never shed their leaves. That's why they remain ever green. Okay, and that too, the thick canopies of the trees. Here you can see, children, the thick canopies of the trees, children, they prevent the sunlight to fall on the ground. So because the sunlight cannot fall on the ground because of this thick canopy, the land always remain wet. See what kind of trees you can find over here. So children, you can find the hardwood trees. Why the wood is very hard in this region is, the wood is pest resistant, because right from their childhood, from a small sibling to the tree, they were grown in that kind of temperature and the rainfall. No, that's why these trees are pest resistant, and they are very luxuriant also. They are very costly, commercially most important trees. So what are those? Rosewood, ebony, mahogany, cinchona, etc. Children, have you ever seen a rosewood bed or teak wood bed? Okay, so those are very costly woods. Understand, children? Now let's see some amazing facts, children. Here, what do you see? Lungs, right, children? So evergreen forests of Brazil, you know Amazon forest, children, they're in Brazil. So these Amazon forests, in which are in Brazil, children, they act as lungs of the world, because the thick trees, children, will prevent, they just, you know, purify the polluted air, and they purify the air. Okay, so that's why they are called lungs of the world. Which are called lungs of the world? The evergreen forests in the Brazil are called lungs of the world. And one more amazing fact over here is anaconda. Children, have you ever seen this anaconda, children? Yes, it's the world's largest snake. This is a very large snake, as it can able to kill and eat the crocodile also. So this kind of snakes are also seen in this evergreen forest of Brazil or Amazon. Okay, now let us discuss about the tropical deciduous forest, children. The word deciduous tells that the trees in these forests shed their leaves. You know why, children? Here in these kind of forest, children, there will be a seasonal variation. Means summer to winter, winter to rainy, like that. The seasons may change. That's why, because of the seasonal variation, trees try to shed their leaves. And they receive less rainfall when compared to evergreen forest, children. Here we will be having dry season. But in the evergreen forest, there is no dry season. So these forests are also called as monsoon forests. Why they are called monsoon forests? You know why? These forests receive rainfall through monsoons. These forests receive rainfall through monsoons. That's why they are called monsoon forests. And you can find this kind of deciduous forests or monsoon forests in the areas, in the countries where they receive monsoons. Okay, see here, some parts of India. In India, children, the maximum parts of India that you can find this kind of deciduous forest. And Australia, Central America, etc. Okay, so here I just told you, children, the important trees. These are the hardwood trees, children. What are the hardwood trees which are available in this tropical deciduous forest? You know, teak, sal, neem, and shisham. These are commercially important trees, children. They are luxurious also. They are very costly. You know why? So this kind of tree, teak wood plants, children, will be used for making of furniture. Okay, that's why they are very much commercially important and they are luxurious also. And what kind of animals you can see commonly here? Tigers, lions, elephants, langurs and monkeys. Langurs also nothing but what? The one type of monkeys only. Okay. So now comes to temperate evergreen forests. See, these are also evergreen forests only, children, but they are lying in the temperate region. Which region? Temperate region. Okay. So those forests are located in the mid latitudes. As I told you that if this is the earth, equator, Tropic of Capricorn, Tropic of Capricorn, Cancer. So mid latitudes means what? From 0 to 90. Mid latitudes are what? 30 to 45 degrees latitudes, children, you can find this kind of temperate evergreen forest. Okay, and that too you can also find this kind of forest in the margins of the coastal regions. Margins, you know, margin means the starting margin will be there, no? So side of the coastal regions. And in which countries you can find this kind of forest, you know, children? Southeast USA, South China, Southeast Brazil, etc. See, all of these countries, if you observe, you can find only one point. South, south, south is common and east also common. It means these forests are found in the southeastern margins of the countries. Okay? And this kind of forest comprising of both the hardwood and softwood trees, children. Trees which are available here are, some of them are hardwood trees, some of them are softwood trees. So what are those? See, oak, pine, eucalyptus, etc. Do you know eucalyptus plant, children, which will be helpful in making of jindu bombs and all, no? So that eucalyptus trees, pines, oak are also available in this region. Pine and oak are softwood trees. This is commercially important tree, children, which may extract eucalyptus oil. Eucalyptus oil. Children, temperate deciduous forests. See here, these are the deciduous forests which are available in the temperate regions. Okay, so these trees, they shed their leaves, that's why they are called deciduous forests. So northeastern parts of USA, China, New Zealand, Chile, Western Europe, all these countries, they will be having this kind of temperate deciduous forests. You have to understand that these all the countries, they experience temperate type of climatic conditions. That's why they are in temperate zone, no? That's why they experience what? Temperate deciduous forests. Okay, so these trees, they shed their leaves in dry season. As I told you, they'll be having some seasonal variations and the trees shed their leaves. And common trees, children, which are found in this region are oak, ash, beech. Oak, ash and beech are the common trees which are found in this region. So these three are softwood trees only. Okay, these softwood trees are very much helpful for making of matchbox, matchsticks, you know, children, matchsticks, ice cream sticks. Okay, and you know, crater boxes, which where they sometimes, you know, they pack the fruits, you know, in some kind of lightweight boxes, wood boxes, you know, those are what, you know, made out of this kind of lightweight trees. And now what kind of animals you can find over there? Deer, foxes, wolves, these kind of animals you can find over there commonly. And what are the common birds you can find there? Peasants, peacocks and peahens also. So both of them you can call them as what? Peasants. And monos. Monos also one kind of, some kind of birds, children, which we sing. Okay, so these are the birds which you can find in this region, and these are the animals which you can find in this region. Okay, these are the common trees which are available in this region. So with this, I conclude today's class, children. Thank you. Have a nice day.